तो अभी हमने सुना थोड़ी देर पहले ब्रेक में जाने से पहले द पर्सनल स्टोरीज ऑफ स्वप्ना रैना एंड अंजलि रैना ऑन व्हाट दे हैड टू गो थ्रू एंड देन वी ऑल्सो काइंड ऑफ एंडेड दैट टॉक ऑन हाउ द मूवी कश्मीर फाइल्स एक्चुअली बिकेम अ वेरी बिग कैटलिस्ट इन टर्म्स ऑफ पीपल टॉकिंग अबाउट इट and other people listening to it. And jaise maine kaha tha show ki shuruaat mein aur break pe jaane se pehle ki now I'll talk to a couple of people who are actually somehow kahin na kahin se unka idea tha jo germinate hoke eventually became this movie the Kashmir Files. So right now I have with me on air Mr. Surinder Kaul from Houston and Sunil Hali from New York, New Jersey. Surinder ji, Sunil ji, welcome to Radio Zindagi.
Thank you Sunny ji for having me and good evening Sunil ji, good to have you.
Thank you, Dr. Rab, and this is Sunil Hali, and thank you, Sunny, for inviting us.
No, thank you, both of you. So, tell me something, ki this Kashmir Files ka idea jo tha, wo Vivek Agnihotri ko somehow aap se baatcheet karke mila, like, tell me something about it.
This idea, obviously, it was created with a group of people, and Dr. Kaul is the pioneer front for that. Let him tell you.
So, let me walk through, Sunny ji. You know, Kashmir, what happened, the way we became victims of genocide and ethnic cleansing in independent India, this was the biggest tragedy. And over a period of time, we realized that nobody knew about it. And there were certain agencies who were trying to keep this story under the wrap. And eventually, for the last 10 years, we have been trying hard. We get in touch with Bollywood director and get this tragedy on the screen, on the set. But we had a lot of difficulties. We approached some Bollywood directors. We talked to them. But they just tried to provide a cold shoulder. And they didn't say no. But they thought, okay, let's do this thing. Let us bring this angle in this movie. Let's try to bring this thing in this movie. We said, no, this is a movie which has to show what terrorism does to the communities, how it disrupts lives, and how the struggle of those who are the victims happen. They were a little bit trying to just romanticize or add something. Anyhow, it didn't gel, but our efforts were on, and it was in year 2018 that I got a chance meeting with Vivek Agnihotri, the director, and at that time he was emerging as a very strong voice in Indian cinema who was trying to unearth some of the very sensitive and complex topics. So that happened, that meeting in Houston, and basically I walked him through about this whole genocide and ethnic cleansing, what happened. It was a little bit detailed meeting. So at that time he was not forthright what he will be doing, but at that time we wanted that would like him to have a documentary. We have some money and whatever, $100,000, so whatever he can make. But anyhow, he listened to us and then he went back. And just after 1 month, I received a call from him. And he said that, hey, I had a discussion with my wife, with my family, because Kashmir is a very complex thing. It has a lot of sensitivities. But I have decided that I'm going to make a feature film based on the truth. So I need your support. So that was a moment, basically, that was the seed that was sown in of the Kashmir Files in Houston.
So basically, if I just recap what you just said, you and of course a bunch of Kashmiri Pandits here in the US, you wanted to highlight the story and basically have a documentary made, and you were trying to reach out to Bollywood. Eventually, you got a chance to meet Vivek Agnihotri in 2018, who initially listened to what you had to say, and then eventually when he went back, he said, yes, he will go ahead and make a feature film. But did you have any idea at that time ki ab ye jo film banayenge, ye sach mein wohi darshayegi jo aapko lagta hai ki hona chahiye, ya aapko tab bhi thoda sa doubt tha because of, you know, how Bollywood usually goes off track many times?
Dekhiye, jo global Kashmiri Pandit diaspora hai, that has been the initiator, that has been the intellectual research and logistic partner of. So we have been associated right from the first step to the last step in this whole journey. So we knew exactly what's going to come. We facilitated around 700 testimonials all around the globe. And kudos to both Vivek Agnihotri and Pallavi Joshi, who came to so many cities in U.S., went to the first-hand victims of this genocide and ethnic cleansing in their home and had a long-format interview with all of them. So he drove around 100 miles to some of the victims who were living a little bit in the interior. So similar exercise we facilitated in UK, we facilitated in various cities in India, and also where people from Germany, Australia, New Zealand, where all these victims, they got in touch. And based on those 700 testimonials, he wrote a script and basically went into the shooting mode. And now we have the final product, which is kicking all over the globe.
That's fantastic. And Sunil ji, of course, maine global Kashmiri diaspora aur aapka naam aur Radio Zindagi ka naam, it comes in the one of the first slides.
Sunil ji, I want to steal that. I don't want to let him to speak.
Please go ahead, sir. Please karo steal up.
Sunil, dekhiye yahan pe US mein, I had requested Vivek ji that you start the private screening in US. Kyunki I was always concerned ki that if this movie will go and will be privately screened in India, so wahan pe isme yahi cheeze hongi jo ki is samay humko sunne mein aa rahi. So, and he agreed basically. So basically we did the logistics. Yahan pe US mein 16 screening hui, and then there were around 25 impact screenings. And some of them were in very prestigious institutions like Capitol Hill and in the Holocaust Museum in Washington, D.C. And in this whole game, when we were starting, kaise karenge, kya karenge, so Sunil Hali ji took upon himself how to do it, because he is an expert in these things. He does it all the time. But he put the whole logistics together. So he was the leader of this, and we were following his instructions. And he did it so meticulously. You know, it's not easy to have a screening in a theater for one show. They may say you need to have the screen for at least 7 days. So how he brought in the logistic support, connected with all the theaters all over the U.S., you know, it was a operational nightmare. But the way he led this whole effort, hats off to him.
Absolutely.
So I just wanted to steal that moment.
You said it very right, because being an actor and filmmaker myself, I know how hard it is to actually, agar film bana bhi lo, usko showcase karna kitna mushkil hota hai. And I also know personally Sunil Hali ji, you know, is line mein kab se hain. Sunil ji, tell me tell me something about it, jo bhi the whole experience of, you know, doing all this and your involvement in this.
Thank you, Dr. Saab. Thank you once again, Sunny. Like Dr. Saab said, that, you know, actually I was outside Olive Garden when I get a call from my elder brother, Rakesh Kaulji. One day he said, do we need to talk to you? And Dr. Kaul, Surinder Kaul, was also on the line. And the rest of it, what you heard from him, was shared with me. And I'll be very honest with you that since my childhood, because I come from a part of Kashmir, Srinagar, and since my childhood, I've always heard about Kashmir as an issue, never solved. And then I distinctly remember my dad being very, very anxious to go back to Kashmir at any cost. He would be even willing to walk up to Kashmir if it was a choice for him. But obviously, that was not a choice. I've been always thinking about, if anything has to be solved in India, it is the Kashmir problem. And how do we do it? And what I've seen in recent administration and the administrations before this in America, which is a very strong force behind whatever happens in India, good or bad. You talk to a senator, a congressman, anybody you talk to, they have an opinion about India. And when the Article 370 was dropped, they had an issue about it, and they were all talking about humanity. So I met several of them, and, you know, I mentioned to them that, have you been to Kashmir? Question is very clear to you, but you have never been to Kashmir. And you're all evaluating what has happened there through the sieve of straight, simple chapter of humanity. But you have no clue what happened to Kashmir. In one fine night, suddenly a community was completely uprooted, and you're trying to teach her laws of humanity. And on the other hand, I told them that, look, what was done to Kashmir after Article 370, okay, internet was taken out and Facebook, social media was stopped. But was there even a single leader, chief minister, home minister, this minister, that minister? Nobody was killed. They were asked to stay home because they didn't want any kind of pain in the market. So I always felt we need to do something about this. We need to have America understand. We need to, our own people from India who live in America, understand what has happened to Kashmir, because Kashmir has been always seen as a place for honeymoon, or it is a place of vacation. or everybody calls it a heaven on earth, but nobody knows what has happened to that part of the world. It's like a book from which one page has been just plucked. It will never belong there. History will never know what happened here. And here is a gentleman who has put all the effort with his team, put a film together. So that's when we decided we need to go about it and we need to showcase it to the people in America in three different categories. One is obviously our own fellow Indians, especially the ones who are not from Kashmir. Number two, the policymakers who have an opinion without knowing much about it. Number three, recently we have seen in many American universities, they are teaching them things about India against India or the specific majority community, which is the Hindu community against them. They need to be given the truth. That's all mission is about. And I asked Vivek if you can see the film, because it's a very important part of the journey that we are going to embark on. And obviously the film was not ready. So me and Surinderji would almost talk every day, and he was willing to put up with my odd hours, and I'm grateful to him because, you know, I have too many challenges that I've taken. But this was the biggest challenge. But I'll tell you, Sunny, when I sat back and thought about the logistics, the biggest fear I had was, how do we convince a Cineplex in America for giving us in one theater, on one screen, for one day, one show for a foreign film? How do you do that on the peak of Thanksgiving to Christmas time? Second challenge that was in my mind was that we are in the middle of Corona and we are going to do private screening. If anybody gets a Corona in any theater, rest of the tour is done and me and Surinderji will be crucified. Number three, my biggest fear was that these two ambassadors who are spearheading this campaign, Alvi and Vivek, they are traveling all over the country. If something happens to them regarding their health, I'm talking, or they catch Corona, we are dead. We don't have ambassadors. We don't have the leaders to walk around it. And the last part was, which was Vivek's and Pallavi's biggest fear, because the film was not yet released, how can they give us the print? If we don't have the print, how do we screen it? And how do we manage that this doesn't get pirated? Besides, that prints have to make it to different cities on time, because there is a small window we get to test it, and then we get a very small window to screen it. One thing I've learned on my life is we all try very hard to do many things, but when God is on your side, nothing can stop you. This is an extraordinary experiment that Surinderji agreed to do, Vivek agreed to do, and Pallavi agreed to do. And finally, we cannot remain more grateful to some of the people, including Priya Savant, who was instrumental. Then there are leaders from every city, how Surinderji created these groups in every city. These are our soldiers who got together, and these are very busy, very, very, professional people who had to take out their time to go and see the film.
So, let me ask you one thing. When you were trying to screen this film, did you get any opposition in terms of because of the content of the film? Ya us time pe ye itni choti si koi cheez thi, kisi ne care nahi kiya?
Actually, this was one of the fears that some of us had. I never had this fear. I knew once the people see the film after the first screening, and Surinderji actually did that experiment in Houston, the last show on 31st of December or 30th December. He invited people from the Muslim community, and some of them guests were from Pakistan. None of them, whether it is the whites, the Chinese, the Americans, the Indians, anybody who saw the film, one thing was very clear. They were very disturbed. They were moved. They were emotional. Of course, people have different opinions about political side of it and this side of it. But the majority of the content speaks about only one thing, why and how one community was just uprooted in one night. And nobody, you can't point out at one government. This is not about one government or a chief minister, prime minister. This is about the lack of complete compassion. In 32 years, we have seen many governments. Not a single person has done anything. In fact, I have very strong view about it. Today, everybody, including the recent chief minister of Delhi, has come forward and made mockery of it, unfortunately, and God willing that he has, God bless him, he or his family has never suffered because of it. He has a point, I agree with him, but the way they make mockery of it in the Vidhan Sabha, and you have all these people who have opinion on the Facebook pages about it this way or that way, I wonder, where have they been for 32 years? Not a single post has been put by all these people who have all the objections. Just because Global Kashmir Diaspora came forward under the leadership of Dr. Surinder Kaul and from a small thought created this big historical document. So now they all have opinion, but they were never there. Not a single person that I know of from these people have gone to Kashmir or Jammu to offer a single student a scholarship, a medicine, food, tent, not a single penny. But suddenly, because somebody who put his life in danger, there is a fatwa against it, Vivek and his wife go out with their daughter and the whole team to build a film, and now they all have their opinion. Where were you for 32 years?
I think it's also great what's happening right now, because I always say it's not always people who come to support something. Sometimes you also understand about a product, about an incident, by looking at the people who actually oppose it. So I think this is great what's happening right now, because कई लोगों की पोल वो खुद ही खोल रहे हैं, विच इज ग्रेट, लेट देम डू इट, बट वी आर रनिंग शॉर्ट ऑफ टाइम राइट नाउ. बट सुनील जी, सुरेंद्र जी, आई कैन नॉट थैंक यू एनफ फ्रॉम नॉट जस्ट कश्मीरीज बट यू नो द एंटायर इंडियन कम्युनिटी for starting this whole project, which actually ended up in the Kashmir Files, where every Indian, every international person can actually see what happened in Kashmir, which many of them, most of them, were unaware of. So thank you, Dr. Kaul. Thank you, Sunil Haliji, for joining today and telling us.
Before we close it,
yes,
I want to
please
reconfirm what you just said. This is not about Kashmir. This is about human beings. They could be in Germany, they could be in Palestine, they could be in Azad Kashmir, they could be in India, anywhere. The whole objective, the whole moral of the story, whole purpose behind this film, I want everybody in this world to see the film, is this should not happen. No single community should be uprooted from their homeland, because then it is impossible to put them back. And number two, that we should not make any kind of fun, any kind of comments, even if there is a political undertones about it. We have nothing to do with that. Let's look at the real objective, that a community was uprooted, they should be put back. And that is all this film is about. Let's put that page back into the book, and hopefully this book should not have another page of the same sort anywhere in the world.
Absolutely. And I think that's the goal of this thing. Because thank you so much, Dr. Kaul.
Thank you so much for your time. Thanks for inviting me.
Thank you, Dr. Kaul. Houston, I know
this is a revolution.
Absolutely.
It's a revolution in making.
Absolutely. And thank you for giving time. I know thoda late hai aap dono ke liye, but thank you so much for joining in.
You are listening to Radio Zindagi. Jiye Jaao.